Hello everyone, in this presentation we will explain the first case carried out in 2014 with the Presto technique, long before it was described. The implantation of the supra-stent via retrograde was an improvisation as we will see below. First of all, comment on the material necessary to perform the technique. It is essential to have a micropuncture set, microcatheter and 300 cm long wires, both for work and recanalization, to be able to maintain the through and through. At the same time, it is important to have high-pressure balloons, since this technique is intended to treat proximal lesions in highly calcified SFA. If we can have lithotripsy balloons available, it will be fantastic to correctly prepare the vessel. The patient in question was a 78-year-old man with critical ischemia of the left leg, presenting rest pain. He presented the usual risk factors and the ultrasound study revealed a 3.8 cm abdominal aortic aneurysm and severe calcification of the iliac axis as well as the superficial femoral artery. The study showed a critical stenosis in the proximal SFA and an occlusion at distal SFA with absence of Doppler flow in the foot. The patient had a very closed iliac bifurcation with extreme calcification, so we decided on a brachial approach to be able to treat the lesion in the proximal SFA as well as the distal occlusion, avoiding the contralateral route as it is a complex bifurcation. Here we can see the aortic aneurysm, the severe calcification in its closed angle. Here we can see the superficial femoral artery with a highly calcified lesion at its origin, hemodynamically significant in the ultrasound study. Here we can see the occlusion with recanalization at the distal level of the SFA. Good outflow through the popliteal artery, with disease of the distal vessels, occlusion of the anterior and posterior tibial artery. Distal runoff through the posterior tibial artery that recanalizes through collaterals, and later the anterior tibial artery is visualized. In this case we successfully performed an antegrade recanalization from the brachial approach, and proceeded to perform simple prolonged angioplasty of the occlusion. We see a residual dissection after angioplasty, so it was decided to pass a supra-stent from the humeral approach. Here we had the first problem. The length of the device did not allow us to reach the distal recanalization area, in order to cover the entire lesion. For this reason, we decided to perform a retrograde puncture of the distal superficial femoral artery using the non-sheath technique to minimize trauma. The objective was to obtain a through-and-through that would allow us, by tensioning the wire at both ends, to advance the supra-stent to the distal area from the humeral approach. Here we can see the double wire, one from the anterograde approach, and the O18 wire from the retrograde approach. Trying to minimize trauma to the artery, we pass the dilator of the 5 French sheath to allow the passage of the stent through the skin and its entry into the artery from the retrograde puncture. In this angiography we can see how we flush the stent at the origin of the superficial femoral artery, achieving a very precise release. We remove the guide wire from the antegrade approach and proceed to release the stent. In this angiography we can see how it is perfectly positioned. It should be noted that the friction of the carrier system with the skin forced us to do a pullback release to achieve the correct deployment. We added one more device from the retrograde approach to finish covering the residual dissection. To say that this second device can be released from the antegrade approach, but in this case, being a tall patient, the system did not reach us. As a result of this inconvenience, our first presto technique arose when it had not yet been described. So we performed the first presto technique, without knowing it, in 2014. Here we can see the angiographic control from the proximal sheath while we release the second stent, avoiding its exit through the retrograde approach. Here we can see the final result, with perfect deployment of the stent at the origin of the SFA. Here we can see the total coverage of the occlusion. And in this final angiography, we can see that there are no complications at the distal puncture point, after compression with an angioplasty balloon for 10 minutes. This technique emerged as an alternative resource given the impossibility of implanting the supra-stent via an antegrade approach, which is why we came up with its passage through a retrograde access. This is a safe alternative, and here we give you some recommendations. Use this technique in cases of calcified lesions of the proximal SFA, or recanalized lesions of patients with a previous surgery with a stump ligature of the SFA. Use a lateral oblique projection to correctly visualize femoral bifurcation. Avoid the use of this technique in cases of small superficial femoral artery, 4 mm. The through and through is very important to advance the material. Vessel preparation is mandatory, minimum 1 mm above the supra, direct from the anterograde approach. Avoid, if it's possible, the use of a sheath to minimize the retrograde access trauma. Largest diameter vessel is the best option. In case of non-sheath technique, remember to push back the system for the correct supra deployment. Ends the procedure from the anterograde approach. Performs correct overlapping of the stents, always releasing from largest to smallest diameter. Thank you very much.